Hello. Welcome, welcome. My name is Nicola. And this will be an all levels yoga practice. I'm having some body issues today. My back has been acting up for a while. It's really bothering me this morning. I have a problem with one of my hips. It all falls apart after a certain age, trust me. But keeping that in mind, I will try to show all the options, but I probably will take some of the modifications along the way, just depending on how I feel. And that's a lesson, listen to your body. You don't always have to go full out if it's not your day today. Take it easy. No shame, no judgment, don't beat yourself up. So today's practice, I want to call it the yin and yang of yoga. We'll be doing a few longer holdings of the stretches, some yin style yoga postures, and then we'll be going into a little power flow and then finishing off with a restore. So just come into your breath, begin to focus on yourself, scan your body, see how you feel. If you are working with injuries or limitations, just keep that in mind and modify where necessary. So turning your attention inward, just come into some slow, deep breaths. And if you can, inhale and exhale through the nose. And just begin to soften the belly. Allow belly to expand on the inhale. And on your exhale, just actively draw your belly button in, pulling it back towards your spine. Make sure shoulders are relaxed, you're sitting up nice and tall, plenty of room for the breath. On your next inhale breath, allow belly and then ribs to expand. As you exhale, actively draw in your rib cage, draw in the belly. Two distinct parts to the breath. Tuning in to how you feel, maybe setting an intention for yourself for today's practice, setting the tone for the practice, and just bearing in mind that I am just a guide. This is your own personal yoga journey. You do not have to look like anybody else doing these postures. In fact, most likely you won't, because everybody, their bodies are different. They're structured differently. People are at different levels of physical fitness. People are working with injuries. So make this your own practice and be okay with that. So just bringing in the third and final part of our three-part breath. On your next inhale, allow belly, rib cage, then collarbones to expand. On your exhale, collarbones fall, ribs draw in, belly button pulls in. Filling up your lungs from bottom to top, emptying from top to bottom.
Sad way I already know, so I will not.
Taking one more deep full inhale breath. Complete your exhale. And then just allow breath to be natural without too much thought. If you do find your mind wandering throughout the practice, bring your attention back to the breath and just listen to the sound of your own breathing. Check in with yourself. As long as you're breathing slowly, deeply, evenly, you're doing okay. If you find yourself breathing rapidly or catching your breath, probably means you need to back off a little bit, that you're just trying to push yourself a little bit too far. So just keep that in mind, and we'll begin by moving onto the back. So however you can get there, maybe just supporting yourself on the back of your thighs, rolling back here. Keep your legs bent, feet flat on the mat, and just connect your low back to the mat. Just note how that feels, abdominals working a little bit to help push low back down to mat, arms are by your sides. And as you inhale, raise your arms up and just allow your low back to disconnect from the mat. Then as you exhale, pushing your arms back down to your sides, connect low back with mat. Inhaling, low back releases, arms coming overhead. Exhale, connecting low back to mat, returning arms to your sides. Just continue at your own pace. And the next time your arms are reaching overhead, just extend your legs long and just take a full body stretch. Your low back will be off the mat. Just allow it to come into a natural position. And then just draw your left knee in and hug it towards your chest. Taking your left hand on top of your knee, releasing right arm by your side. Just begin to make some circles here, moving into this hip. Just try to keep the leg fairly passive. Use your arm to determine the size of these circles. And just pausing, circle in the opposite direction. And then drawing the knee in once more, begin to extend and bend the leg. If hamstrings are tight, you will not fully straighten your leg, and that's okay. Extend to where you feel a good sensation, a good stretch in the back of the leg. And next time leg is extended to your own degree, just pause. If you want, we can add a little core work here. Just take hold of your leg somewhere, just avoiding behind the knee. Just bring your leg as far as it comfortably comes in. Tighten your core. On your exhale, just roll head and shoulders off the mat. Maybe picking up right heel an inch off the mat, bringing nose toward knee. Slowly lower head, shoulders, right foot to the ground. Release right arm to shoulder height and just allow this left leg to open out to the left side, feeling an inner thigh stretch. Perhaps pointing and flexing your foot, circling the ankle. Just making some small movements, whatever feels natural. Drawing this leg back to center, bend your leg and place your right hand on your knee, left arm comes out to shoulder height. And we'll just draw this knee over across towards the right side, Just be mindful of the low back here. We're pretty early on in the practice. So try to keep your knee approximately at hip height and keep your gaze up towards the ceiling. Extend long, take one more full body stretch here. Inhale, and as you exhale, just draw the right knee in, hug it towards your chest. Releasing your left arm by your side. Just make some circles with this right leg, moving into the hip area. Pausing, circling in the opposite direction. And then drawing the knee in, we'll begin to extend and bend the leg, working into the hamstring. Just extend the leg and pause. Now you can just grab hold of your leg anywhere that's comfortable. And keeping head and shoulders down, just work on increasing the stretch slightly as you breathe. If you want to add some core work, peel head and shoulders off the mat on an exhale, maybe even raising your left foot an inch off the mat. On your next exhale, lower head, shoulders, left foot to the mat. Bring left arm out to shoulder height. And just begin to open your right leg out towards the right. Feeling that inner thigh stretch. Making any small movements that come up, maybe pointing and flexing that right foot or circling the ankle. Slowly drawing this leg back to center. Go ahead and bend your leg. Place left hand on kneecap, open right arm to shoulder height. And find that twist to the left side. Again, just being mindful of the low back, keeping gaze straight up at the ceiling. Your back, just draw your knees in, give them a hug. So we'll be making our way to a seat on the mat. So however you can best get there, you can just rock back and forward or maybe roll onto one side first, finding your way to a seat, bringing the soles of your feet together. Sitting up nice and tall, making sure that you're on those little sit bones there. So we'll be working with turtle. And this is where we'll begin our long holds. Not too long, don't worry. So just make sure your spine is straight and begin to come forward. Even if you only come forward an inch or two and you pause right there, that's perfectly fine. Arms can be on top of your feet. You can rest them on your shins, or perhaps you want to rest your elbows on your shins, interlace fingers, and kind of rest your forehead on your thumb knuckles. To stay here for the entire length of the hold, perhaps feeling yourself easing a half inch further in with every couple breaths. If you think you have a little more flexibility in the spine and hip area, you can kind of lean forward a little bit more, maybe even taking your forearms to the mat underneath your shins. Again, you can keep back fairly straight or begin to round the spine, allowing head to relax forward. Perhaps you can even get your head down onto your feet. I cannot do that, so I will not be demonstrating. But everybody's different. Just make it your own posture. Find that edge and hold it. And you'll feel the edge change as we hold the posture. Take one more breath here. Just begin to come up to a nice tall seat. Keep your legs where they are. Take your arms behind you. Let your fingertips point whichever way feels natural. And draw your shoulder blades together, opening up the chest for seated fish. You can keep your gaze straight ahead or maybe look up slightly if that's comfortable. Sending your breath to that upper front chest area, allowing it to expand as you inhale. One more breath. As you exhale, just release the chest, the shoulder blades, maybe give your shoulders a little shake and extend the legs out in front. If you need to keep knees bent, please do so. Coming into Dandasana or staff pose. Sitting nice and tall. Core is engaged to help keep you sit up nice and tall. Feet are flexed, pulling your toes back towards your shins. So we'll be coming into a forward fold from here. Again, knees bent is fine. Just begin to lean forward a little bit until you reach that stopping point with a flat back. And you can choose to stay here with a long spine. Or you can begin to round the spine, bringing nose towards knee. Focus on your breath here, that meditative quality. Inhale, exhale. Try to make your inhales and exhales about the same length. You will never be fine.
and send your breath to any areas of deep sensation. Just helping those areas to kind of release, relax, help you a little deeper into the posture. Could be the low back here, it could be the back of the legs. It's just a visual. And just keep in mind that you should not be feeling any pain or discomfort. If you are, just back off a little bit. Don't force. Yoga's not about forcing, it's about listening. So just listen to your body. Focus on your breath. Just take one more breath here. And then slowly make your way up to a tall spine. And just draw in your left leg. You can keep the foot to the inside of your thigh or cross it over. It really doesn't matter, just personal preference. Keep your front foot flexed. Inhale to sit nice and tall, and as you exhale, just begin to twist towards the left side. So you can just hug your knee, or you can take the arm to the outside of your leg. Most important thing here is try to get up a little taller with each inhale, and maybe twist a fraction more with each exhale, just working your way gradually a little deeper into this twist. Taking one more breath here. On your exhale, just slowly release the twist. Extend both legs, maybe give them a little shake. And then draw the right leg in. Sitting nice and tall, maybe crossing the leg to the outside of the left thigh. Inhale the spine nice and long. Exhale, begin to twist. Left foot is flexed. Inhaling, stretch a little taller. Exhale, twist a little deeper. Bringing out the spine. Taking one more breath. Exhale, release the twist. Release your legs, shake your legs. Just make your way onto all fours. And continue loosening up the spine just with a little cat-cow. So find a nice tabletop position. Draw your belly button up. Spread your fingers nice and wide. As you inhale, belly lowers and tailbone and chin look up. And as you exhale, really round that back. Arch the spine, tuck in your chin and tailbone.
Inhaling, find that cow or dog posture. Exhale into cat, push into your hands and knees, tucking everything in. Core is activated. Just flow back and forth with the rhythm of your own breath. Just a couple more sets here. One more inhale breath, exhale, come to a neutral spine. We'll be finding downward facing dog here. So make sure things are spread nice and wide, hands a little forward of shoulders. And just begin to lift your hips high, straighten the legs. Pushing heels towards the floor, push into your palms. Pushing chest back towards your thighs. Drawing shoulder blades down your back and then wrapping them forward and tipping that tailbone up and back. Begin to walk your feet forward towards your hands, landing in a forward fold. If forward folds are not for you, your option is jackknife, keeping head and heart at the same level. If you are in your forward fold, just let everything relax forward. Don't force. If hamstrings are tight, bend your knees and rest your belly on your thighs. Head and neck hanging loose. Just let the tension fall away. Relax your jaw, relax your shoulders. And then on your next inhale, we'll find jackknife briefly. And then lowering your hips, we'll be making our way into Utkatasana or chair pose. You want to avoid a sway back, so tuck your hips down. Several options with the arms. They can reach straight overhead, or maybe Anjali Mudra prayer pose, or maybe you like to do goalpost arms or cactus arms. We'll be adding a twist, moving to the left side. So options are to just simply open up, bringing the back of your hand to the outside of your knee, left arm reaches up. If you want to twist a little deeper, sink your hips lower first and get your elbow to your knee. Make a fist, press your left palm on your fist, making sure spine is straight, twist. Twists come from the waist up and they should be done with a straight spine, not a rounded spine. Just like with the seated twist, as you inhale, try to think about working your spine a little longer. As you exhale, just twisting a little more. Take one more breath, and then kind of work your way back into that forward fold or jackknife. Coming to jackknife as you inhale, sinking the hips, finding chair or Utkatasana. We'll stay here for a breath or two before we add the twist. And just remember your options for the twist. On your next exhale, you can simply open up the arms and twist, or sink the hips a little lower, bringing elbow to knee, making a fist. With that left arm, pushing an open right palm and working your way into the twist. Focus on the breath. Inhale, spine lengthens. Exhale, twist a little more. Try to stay for one more breath. And then go ahead and find that forward fold one more time. Now as you inhale, push into the feet, reaching up to extended mountain, bringing hands to heart. And we'll just continue with some sun breaths here. So inhale, reaching up, exhale, palms push down. Inhale, bringing palms together, then turn hands out, push the palms down. Create a little bit of resistance with your own arms. So adding on, we'll begin sun salutation A. Inhale, reach up tall. Exhale, soften your knees, forward fold. Inhale, halfway to jackknife. Exhale, fold. Inhale, stepping back, finding plank, or you can come to a tabletop. Shift forward slightly. Exhale, lower down. Perhaps you want to challenge yourself and hover, or you lower all the way down. Coming to low cobra, high cobra, or taking knees off the mat, pushing into tops of feet for upward facing dog. Exhale, find downward dog. Just take a breath here. On your next inhale, soften your knees and look forward. Exhale, begin to walk your feet forward, landing in a fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweeping arms out and up. Exhaling, hands to heart. Two more of these. Inhale, reach up. Every movement linked to breath. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Stepping back, finding plank or tabletop on your inhale. Exhale, slowly lower. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, soften knees, look forward. Exhale, walk or hop towards the front. I will not be leaping today because of my back. Inhale, come halfway up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reaching up tall. Exhale, hands to heart. One more set just like this before we add on. Inhale, reach. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Finding your plank or tabletop on your inhale. If you're in a plank, shift forward a little. Exhale, lower. Challenge yourself. Hover, hover, hover. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward dog. Soften knees, look forward. Exhale, walk or hop to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway to jackknife. Exhale, fold. Sweeping arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart. Adding on. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, come chair pose. And then fold forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Stepping back, finding plank or tabletop. Exhale, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, down dog. Soften knees, look forward. Step your right foot forward. Lower back knee. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands down. Stepping back to plank, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Softening knees, step left foot forward, knee down. Inhale, reach. Exhale, hands down. Finding downward dog here. Come to plank. Lower down, Upward dog. Downward dog.
Soften knees, look forward. Walk towards the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Finding chair pose. Inhale, reach up tall. Exhale, hands to heart. Two more. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Finding plank or tabletop. Exhale, slowly lower.
Upward dog.
Downward dog. Bend your knees, bring left foot forward. Knee down. Inhale, reach. You can choose to keep the back knee up here if you want. Exhale, hands down. Stepping back to plank. Lower. Upward dog. Downward dog. Stepping your right foot forward, knee up or down. Inhale, reach. Exhale, hands down. Stepping back to plank. Inhale here, exhale, lower. Upward dog. Exhale, down dog. Softening your knees, walk or hop to a forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Coming through chair pose. Inhale, reach your arms, then stand up tall. Exhale, hands to heart. One more time. Inhale, come through chair pose. Fold forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Finding plank or tabletop with your inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, down dog. Stepping left foot forward. You can stay with the high lunge or take another knee down lunge. Exhale, hands down. Finding plank, lower down. Coming to upward dog. Downward dog. Bending knees, right foot steps forward, knee up or down. Inhale, reach tall. Exhale, hands down. Stepping back once more, find plank, chaturanga down. Hold, 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 challenge yourself. Upward dog. Downward dog. Inhale, looking forward, walk or hop to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold, bending the knees, sinking, finding chair pose on an inhale, push up tall, exhale, hands to heart. And just pause. Building heat, heart beating a little faster, breathing a little faster. So lowering your hands. A wide stance on your mat. Take your toes to the corners of your mat. So feet are on a slight angle, maybe 45 degrees. Bending your knees here. Finding goddess. Just take a few breaths here and we'll be moving right to left through some standing postures. So from here, just kind of pivot on your feet. Finding warrior two. Front toes to 12 o'clock. Back toes are at like 9 o'clock. Take one more breath. Make your way back to goddess. Inhale, exhale, finding warrior two to the right. Bending that front knee, trying to keep knee and ankle in line. Take an inhale. Exhale, find your goddess. Find warrior two to the right. Left. To the left.
Now I'm getting my left and rights mixed up. Yoga makes me very dyslexic. From here, reach back, finding peaceful warrior or crescent warrior. Come forward on your exhale, extended side angle, choosing to keep elbow on your knee or reaching down to the mat. Inhale back to warrior two. Come to center, find your goddess. Going to the right side now. Warrior two. Flipping front palm. Find that peaceful or crescent warrior. Inhale and an exhale. Extended side angle. Again, keeping elbow on thigh or reaching down. You might have to sink your legs a little bit lower to avoid hiking this hip up if you're reaching down. Back to warrior two, back to goddess. Switching to the other side, find your warrior two. Flip the front palm, find peaceful warrior. Come out to extended side angle, your version. We'll try to hold here for a few breaths. If you like the bind, you can add the bind here just by reaching this front arm under, taking your top arm in back and trying to connect your fingers. If you are in the bind, go ahead and release and begin to straighten your front leg, turning this into triangle. So arms are reaching floor to ceiling. Legs are fairly straight. Soft knees is recommended. Don't want to lock out the knee joints. And we'll be turning this into a standing runner. So the best way is probably just to pivot over so you're facing your front foot. And then bring your hands down. You can also bring your hands to your thigh. You just want to turn your toes so both sets of toes face forward. And find your version of standing runner. Remembering knees can be soft and you could be up here. Take one more breath here. And then as gracefully as you can, just make your way back to warrior two. So shift your back foot a little bit so you can set the heel down. Bend into your front knee, maybe windmill your arms over. And then find goddess. Take a breath here, feeling strong, feeling powerful. Let's go to the right side, warrior two. Flipping front palm, finding peaceful warrior. Coming to your extended side angle, remembering your options, elbow to thigh, reaching down, or perhaps you want to add the bind. Wherever you are, just focus on your breath. Find a stable focal point, a drishti. When you try your best, but you don't succeed. If you are in the bind, release the bind and we'll come into triangle, straightening the front leg, reaching hands floor to ceiling. Remembering you can always support yourself on this front shin, or if you happen to have a yoga block handy, you can place it under your front arm. Keep this top shoulder back. and finding standing runner. So you need to face the right side of your mat, pivot your back foot, and send both sets of toes facing forward, finding your version of standing runner. Remembering you could be up here, you could have bent legs. As long as you're feeling some stretch in the hamstrings, then the posture's doing its job. You don't want to be in pain. Breathing slowly, deeply, evenly. Breathing into any areas of deep sensation, encouraging those areas to relax, to release. Take one more breath. Making your way up, bending your front knee, set your back heel down so your toes point towards the long edge of the mat. Windmill your arms, finding that warrior two. One more goddess. Sink a little lower. Feeling fierce, feeling strong. Inhale, five-pointed star. Exhale, hands down. Just kind of work your feet together here. Stand towards the front of your mat. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, dive forward. Find your downward dog. And we'll be making our way down to the mat. So you can come onto knees and lower down that way, or you can try one more chaturanga. If you're up for a challenge, slowly, slowly lower. Hover, hover, hover. As long as you can. You got this. One more breath. Then lower yourself down. And we'll be working with Sphinx. So begin by extending your arms long, bringing forehead down to mat. And just kind of draw your arms back until your elbows are kind of just under your shoulders there, maybe a little further forward. Connect palms to mat, connect forearms to mat, and then pull back on your arms. It's going to pull your chest forward. Tuck your pelvis. Engage the glutes, push your pelvis down towards the mat, and draw belly button up and in. All this will help to protect the low back. You're pushing your feet into the floor. Head can stay down, or you can look forward. And just make sure you're up out of the shoulders here. You don't want to be sinking down. Core is engaged, glutes are engaged. Pelvis is pushing down, pulling back on your arms, working up a little sweat here. This is quite an intense posture. Perhaps lowering the chin, maybe allowing it to move from side to side to release the neck a little bit, making some half circles here. Try to hang in here for another breath or so. Take one more breath. And just begin to lower down, bending your knees. Just windshield wiper your legs from side to side, giving some release to the low back. And then lowering the legs, bring hands to either side of your ribs, push up onto your knees, and then make your way back to child's pose. We'll just rest here for a couple of breaths, just counteracting that back bend. You can keep arms extended forward, or just draw them back so that they rest next to your feet.
allowing shoulders to relax forward. Take one more breath here, and come to a nice tall spine. And we'll just make our way down onto the back. So find a seat towards the center of your mat. You can challenge the core, or you can keep legs bent and hold onto the back of your thighs as you roll down. Draw your knees in. Bring the soles of the feet towards the ceiling, legs are bent, and try to grab hold of either your insteps of your feet, your shins, or maybe just rest your arms on the back of your thighs. Rocking gently from side to side here, or maybe bending and straightening your legs. And just letting go of your feet, bring your feet down to the mat. Keep your right foot grounded, bring your left ankle below your right knee. Keep your low back connected to mat. And just kind of gently push your left knee away. Coming into figure four stretch or reclining position. So your option is to stay here or just bring the right foot off the mat, join right knee in. You'll feel the stretch in the left hip really increase. Breathing into that area of sensation, encouraging it to release. Take one more breath. And just bring your foot down to the mat. Cross your left leg over the right. Shift your hips an inch or two to the left. And then return to that twist that we did at the beginning. Maybe your low back is a little more flexible now. Maybe your knee can move a little lower towards the mat. Maybe not. Listen to your body. Gaze can stay straight up at the ceiling, or you can turn your head and look out towards your left arm. Taking one more breath. Just roll onto your back, uncross your legs, level off your hips. Just maybe take a moment here to windshield wipe your knees from side to side. To stillness, keeping left leg grounded. Bring your right ankle just below left knee. Connect low back to mat. Push that right knee away. And feel free to stay here. Or just bring this left foot off the ground. Bring your left leg in a little closer. Feeling that stretch intensify in the right hip. Breathing into that area. Take one more breath, and then release your foot down to the mat, cross your right leg over the left, shift your hips an inch or two to the right, bringing your knees over, across and down towards the left side, just being mindful of your low back. Just take one more breath here. And then slowly make your way onto your back, uncross your legs. And we'll just prepare for Shavasana. So again, you can take a moment to kind of drop your knees gently from side to side. If you have a blanket or a pillow that you want to grab, to help you relax, go for it. And then just make your way to a comfortable position on your mat. If you're laying down, you could rest your legs against the wall if you happen to have some wall space handy. Or maybe keeping knees bent, feet flat on the mat, and just let your knees rest against one another. This will provide no support for the low back. Perhaps just extend your legs long, arms by your side. And just let arms and legs roll out to the side. Just begin to scan your body. Just pay attention to any areas where you might still be holding tension and just let it go. Relax the jaw, relax the shoulders. And just pay attention to where you feel the support of the floor beneath you. Take an inhale breath, and as you exhale, just surrender into the support of the earth. Let it hold you up. Let tension melt away. Let breathing just be natural. Try to keep the mind quiet. Just let thoughts pass as they enter your head.
Om Namah.
begin to make some small movements, bringing your attention back to the present moment, taking in the sounds around you, noting how the air feels on your skin. Just moving slowly, keeping this sense of calm and ease that we've cultivated during Shavasana. Just roll onto one side. Take a few breaths there. Just slowly transition to seated.
Calm down.
And just sit with eyes closed or gaze soft.
Protect your energy. I am protected. I am protected.
Just taking an inhale breath and reaching arms out and up, bringing palms together and drawing hands to heart center. The light in me honors the light in you. Namaste.